What's up, guys? We are casting metal PokeBalls today. So this is a true story. I was trying to find my Mini Metal Foundry and it just disappeared. I checked my side shed, I checked around my workspace, and it was gone. I was about to make a new one, and then last night it finally hit me. You know what I did with it? I stuck a plant in it and turned it back into a plant pot. And I know that that was its original purpose and design, but it's kind of funny that I lost track of it. Okay, so let's jump right in. You remember in the last video, we took wax PokeBalls and we encapsulated them with plaster of Paris, and then I baked those in the oven to melt the wax and leave a cavity where we could pour in molten aluminum. So next item of business, let's get back to the stove, pull out our plaster molds, and see if we can cook up some molten aluminum today. Whew. These things are toasty warm, and the cool thing is they're completely hollow as well. All the wax that was in there melted and dripped out upside down, and I removed that wax and then let them cook overnight at about 325 degrees Fahrenheit. So most of the moisture is cooked out now, and these things are nice and warm, which is really good, but I do have a little bit of a concern though. In a previous video, I tried making a plaster mold of Han Solo and pouring in molten copper, and the heat of the copper was enough to vaporize materials in the plaster, which left bubbles and pockmarks all over the final casting. Will it turn out with a reasonable result? I have no idea. This is purely experimental, so you're seeing this for the first time as I do. And if any of you are experienced metal workers and know of a better way to do this, then please let me know, because I'm here for the experience and the education as well. They're really warm. It's actually starting to burn my hands. So let's go whip up a batch of molten aluminum, pour these molds, and see if they actually work. Now this is a brand new clay graphite crucible, and technically you're supposed to let it run through a cycle of warming up and cooling down, or there's a chance that it could split. But I'm not really that patient, so I'm just gonna throw this thing in, fire it up, and hope that it survives. Okay, so for aluminum scrap here, I've got some of my mini metal biscuits. I've also got this old aluminum master sword. It was a little bit bent and wonky, so we're gonna melt that back down and use it to make some PokeBalls today. Right on, time to fire it up. So I just got this out of the oven. It's extremely hot, but I'm still expecting the molten metal will probably crack the plaster. It's just what it does. But it's completely cleaned out now. Let's set this thing down and pour some metal in. Okay, this thing is molten. Don't want to spill it. That would be very, very bad right now. Still lighting on fire. Now that plaster is still burning. I was wondering if it was gonna do that. So I'm wondering if that's gonna cause imperfections to the metal. I'm hoping that has a chance to settle down before that cures. Maybe we can get a little bit more in there. That was a pretty good pour. I have to say, I'm pretty impressed with myself for not spilling. Even though I cooked these things overnight at 350 degrees, you can see the plaster still releasing flammable gases. So I obviously didn't cook it all off, and we're getting a nice big crack here as the metal starts to cool, but I do have my fingers crossed. I'm hopeful that we're gonna get something good here. We got a crack down the side of my crucible, so we're gonna have to do this quickly. Oh no, I'm out of aluminum. No, that's not good.
Oh no, it just broke in half. You gotta be kidding me. There's 40 bucks down the drain.
We're just gonna salvage as much of this as we can. Another cool design of the Mini Metal Foundry. I should have done that earlier though. That thing has cooled down too long. I think we lost most of it. Okay, so update guys, this is why you follow directions. The crucible maker told me I needed to warm it up and cool it down or it may crack. I was expecting some little cracks. I wasn't expecting it to break in half, holy heck. And that may have cost us one of my PokeBall castings. So check it out guys, we've let these things sit for about an hour. They should be nice and cold now. And you can see the plaster's stopped burning. It's left a nice black residue everywhere. And surprisingly, this metal is actually very warm to the touch. Not so much down here, but up here is still really warm. Unfortunately, I cracked my crucible and lost half of the aluminum before I could get this poured. I think the mold is full, but I'm actually not sure what to expect. I am curious to get inside this and see how it turned out. So let's take these bad boys back inside, grab a hammer, smash them open, see what we got. It took so much work to make these plaster molds, and now we have to smash them open. They are one-time use, you only get one shot. So you're seeing this for the first time, as I do. This thing filled up completely with aluminum. The only way to get our metal mold out now is to smash it with a hammer. Let's get to it. One shot, and check that out. Oh my goodness, you know what? That kind of worked out. The first thing I notice is the cracks and crevices are all filled up with sand and plaster, but I'm thinking if we just took something like a screwdriver, we could probably chisel those out. Even after an hour and a half to 2 hours of cooling down, this thing is still ridiculously hot. Oh, and just as a point of interest, there's that little point on my hand where the liquid nitrogen burned me 2 weeks ago. Just randomly out of nowhere, it started blistering. This thing seems to be in pretty good condition. There was a little bit of shrinkage here, apparently, when the aluminum cooled down, so we don't have a perfect sphere, unfortunately. But the rest of it looks to be in pretty good shape. We got one solid Pokeball. Now I am excited to see the second mold here. Either we have a solid Pokeball, or we have two halves that are joined together. But did they fuse together, or will they fall apart? I guess it's time to find out. Sweet, look at that. It almost looks like the Technodrome. If you're a Ninja Turtle fan from the 80s, you got like the eye on the Technodrome there. This stuff is so brittle, I could probably just pull it apart with my hands. Look at that. So, what did we get here? So far, it's actually looking pretty good. Every sphere we cast, we get air bubbles trapped in the top. So I'm not sure how to avoid that. So you can actually see the seam where the two metals join together. This first pour went up to here, and then the second pour actually joined in there. Let's see if we can get these things cleaned up a little bit, shall we? There we go, I'm gonna use a little wire brush here. Oh yeah, look at the way that just falls away. That actually looks pretty sweet. These things might clean up relatively nice. Ooh, I'm starting to see potential here, guys. So here's the difference after 30 seconds of a wire brush. It's already pretty dramatic. It looks like it turned out great. I kind of like that dirty look to it though. We just cut off the base, round it up a little bit, have ourselves a cool little paperweight, solid metal Pokeballs. That's awesome. So there you have it, guys. I'm actually super surprised that casting in plaster is actually a viable option. And I think if we were to take our silicone molds and our wax sculptures and make them a little bit more perfect, I think those results would show up on our end product as well. What do you want to see me cast next? Put your comments and suggestions down below. Maybe I'll pick one of them and put it to the test in a future video. Thanks for joining me for this series of experiments. It has been awesome hanging out with you. And I will see you in the next video. I'll talk to you then. Cool. The world's first gummy Pokeball.